One man is dead and a canine officer in surgery after a police shooting in Sacramento's Land Park neighborhood. Crocker Riverside Elementary School has just ended a mandatory lockdown. The shooting happened after a man and a woman in a stolen vehicle led police on a chase. This story has our full focus right now. KCRA3's Mae Fasai is live at 3rd Avenue and Marty Way near the spot where the suspects ditched the car. But first, let's go to Mike Dussel live near Riverside and Robertson, where officers caught up with the suspects. Mike?
And Walt, I'm standing at Riverside and Perkins right now. Riverside remains shut down because of this, an officer-involved shooting investigation that is underway right now. Meanwhile, let's swing it over the other way. You can see the line forming for children to be picked up from that elementary school. A lot going on, so let's start with how this all started. Take a look, and it was just around 10 o'clock this morning that Sacramento police say they were pursuing a stolen car. They say that stolen car nearly hit several children here near this school. They abandoned the pursuit but continued to chase the suspects when neighbors called and told they were on foot. They were able to arrest the driver and take her into custody. However, police say the second suspect, a man in his 30s from Chico, actually fired several shots at a police dog, hitting that dog in the face and in the paw. The officer, the handler of that dog, returned fire. The suspect ultimately died here on the scene. Parents, obviously, well, when they heard there was a lockdown and all this was happening just outside the school, they were concerned.
I just want my kids to be safe. I want to get my kids, and we can't get in to get my kids. We can't get in. We both have kids.
Just hearing that this is all happening right near the school, what's the reaction?
It's a little scary. Frightening, because I have a daughter at Crocker Riverside attending right now, and they must be going through some tough times right now.
And back here live, this is a look at Riverside Boulevard. That right there is the morning kindergarten class. They are right now being escorted out by police to the corner of Riverside and Perkins. This is the AM kindergarten class. What has happened here is the police have set up a check-in table right here for parents to check out those students and take them home for the day. This is the normal dismissal time for the AM kindergarten. However, the police department says, and the superintendent said, if there are parents who want to pick up their children in other grades early today, they too can come here to the intersection of Riverside and Perkins. And once these kindergartners are all checked out, they will then accommodate requests to get students out early in other grades. However, the superintendent stresses that the school will continue with its normal day from here on out for all other grades other than kindergarten. The PM kindergarten class, meanwhile, it has been canceled for the rest of the day. So this right now live on television, you are watching the AM kindergartners being reunited from their parents. Some of those parents, as you heard, very concerned about this whole situation, although police say at no point in time were any students in danger during this entire situation. This, a live look at what's going on right now at the intersection of Riverside and Perkins. That's what's going on over here. I'm going to send it back to you for more on this story.
Mike, obviously an emotional reunion with the parents who've known what's been going on this entire time, and probably the kids who don't. Everything seemed to be moving along accordingly. And also, how close is the school to where that second suspect was eventually located?
Well, let's start with the dismissal, and this looks very orderly right now. I mean, they have set up tables here. They are calling parents one at a time, much as you would in a normal school pickup day. This is what happens at AM kindergarten. The parents show up, and once the teacher sees the parent, they release the student to that parent. So this is what is happening right now. And as you said, Walt, this was very emotional for several parents. I talked to one parent when I first got here, before details were even really coming out, and he said he had just got a text from inside a classroom saying that they were in lockdown. So obviously, there was a lot of jittery nerves, and in his words, it was horrifying not really knowing what was going on. But now, as you can see, a lot of happy faces as these children are being released. Second question, Walt, how close is this? Well, literally right across the street is where the suspect was found lying in a yard right at the intersection of Riverside and Robertson's. That's literally right across the street. Not exactly sure where the shooting took place involving the canine, but it was literally right across the street. One other thing I do want to point out, because I know people are going to be interested, that police dog, I am told from the police department, he was shot in the face and in the paw. However, he was taken into surgery just within the last 30 minutes, and I am told that the dog is expected to recover.
Okay. All right, Mike, if we can we get a listen in to the exchange? I see Mrs. Hastings, who's at the front there with the blue top. She's escorting some of the kids out. She's one of the kindergarten teachers. Let's listen in for a minute.
Can I just ask you, what is the feeling knowing that your son is now in your arms?
Well, how are you feeling, Pate? I just concerned of how scared he was, and everything seemed to be okay, and we've got good law enforcement and a good school, and everything was taken care of like it should be, so we're good.
And as a parent, just knowing that you now have him in your arms?
My heart's beating pretty hard right now, so I am very glad to have my baby back. So
thank you. And Walt, let me listen into the rest of this going on.
Amelia?
Yeah. And now Amelia going to her mother.
Mike, having been in that line collecting kids, yeah, the kids are kind of like, what's Mr. Tissell doing here with all the TV cameras? Do they seem to know what had happened, or is it just pretty much normal with reporters like you all over the place?
Well, you know, having a kindergartner, I'm assuming that, you know, when they're in lockdown, they're simply, you know, in a precautionary standpoint where they're not leaving the class or anything. So the kids don't really notice what's going on outside necessarily. And as the kids are coming out, they don't necessarily seem to have any expression on their face other than what you would normally see, other than the fact there's a whole lot of people around here. Let me go over here and see if ask this parent real quick. Excuse me. Hi, Mike from Channel 3.
Hi, Mike. I love you. Always seen the snow.
Well, hey, thank you so much. We're just here, you know, now that students are finally getting reunited with their parents, first and foremost, just what's the reaction getting
relief.
The students?
Definitely relief. We're glad everybody's okay. Definitely relief.
Do you think the students themselves had any idea what was going on?
How about, guys, did you know what was going on today? Did you know?
A vomit.
What did you do in class today? Do you remember what you did in class?
I planted seeds.
So you planted seeds in class this morning, right? So what does that tell you as a mom? Did they really have any idea what was going on?
I think they were good.
They were doing their normal class.
They were. They had a great time, yeah.
Well, hey, thank you so much for talking to us. Walt, I'm going to hit it back to you.
All right, Mike, a very active scene. We thank you. We've got a lot more coming. The kids seem to be fine, and the parents obviously relieved as to what was going on. You can continue to follow this story if you'd like on KCRA.com or on our mobile app. Our crews are constantly updating a live feed of information as the shooting investigation develops this afternoon.